Hello and welcome to Full Frame Nomads. Today I'm going to show you how you can fix problematic sky in Photoshop, whether it was ruined by the usage of a polarizing filter or by any other reason. I think the flow which I will show you works well for all scenarios. So let's show the intro and get started. This is the first image which we are going to work on today. So if you see, the sky is not uniformly lit. Here we have a darker area, here we have lighter area, here again the light is blown out, and if we zoom in, you can see that there is some color bending which mixes with the blue of the sky, and generally the sky is quite problematic. So let's see what we can do about it. This is a quite clear image shot in Greece in the summer, approximately at the same time of the day as the photos we are trying to repair. It is suitable to take this beautiful blue sky and then to try to recover the clouds which were present in the original photos. You need a good resolution photo. This one especially is 48 megapixels, so there is a lot of information, and I can crop only the part of the image which I need, which will be this portion of the sky. It looks okay, but if you zoom, you can see that there is some fine grain which I want to clear. Also here and there are some visible spots which were specks of dust on the lens, so we want to clear them before we start working with this blue sample of blue sky. So let's make a quick repair with the Photoshop spot healing brush tool, which is extremely good and very useful. And okay, let's assume that these were the only spots. Now we want to smoothen out this patch of blue sky. For this purpose, we're going to use the blur filter, and especially the surface blur. I have set it at a radius of 92 and threshold of 24. So you can see when I click what will be the resulting image. Now it is quite smooth, as you see we zoom a lot, and the image looks quite okay. What we can also do is to turn the image in 32 bits, so no matter how much we zoom, we will not have bending in the resulting image. Okay, now we have our patch of blue sky, and what we can do next is to try to apply it here in this problematic image. So what we need to do is to isolate the sky. Let's make a copy of the background layer. Select the sky with the sky selection tool. It works quite well in the last versions of Photoshop. Okay, now what we need to do is to create a mask. Okay, And let's take our patch of blue sky. We need to adjust it a little bit to cover the whole sky area. And now what we need to do is to apply the mask. Okay, so as you can see now, our perfectly created patch of blue sky replaced the original problematic sky, but now it looks a bit artificial and we don't have the clouds. So what we can do is to work a bit on the adjustment of the sky. We can work a bit on the levels, maybe to darken a bit. Okay, don't forget to create a clipping mask in order not to affect the other part of the image, but only the sky. So we can play a little. Maybe it's too dark. Then let's leave it like this. And now we are ready to try to reproduce the clouds which were existing in the original image. So what we can do now is to open a copy of the original image. What we need to do here is to isolate the sky and the clouds. So with the sky selected, we can create a new layer by pressing Ctrl J and taking only the sky. If you go to the red channel, you can see clearly the clouds. Let's make another channel from the red one, copy of the red channel, and let's press Ctrl and left mouse key in order to create selection. Don't forget to click on the RGB channel. So what we need to do now is to take our clouds and move them over to the copy of our image. So now it's looks better. We need to work a little bit on our cloud layer. So let's add adjustment layer with levels and play a little bit, maybe to make them a little lighter. Again, don't forget to create a clipping mask. Okay, now they look better. And if we come back to our original image, as you can see, we quite successfully returned the clouds which were present in the original image. Of course, you can play a little bit more. Okay, now we have the full amount of clouds, and maybe after we flatten our image, we can play a little bit with the levels again. So let's select the sky. Adjustment layer. Here we go. Okay, so if we make comparison with the original image. However, if you don't want to have your original clouds, you can use a specific type of brush which is created with the idea of replace your clouds entirely in your image. My cloud brushes are purchased from Joe Grimes. I will provide a link in the description below. And let's see how they look. Let's turn out all the clouds and leave only our sky. So this is how they work. We go to brush and choose one of the presets, let's say cloud and sky number 3. Okay, we need to increase the size of the brush in order to fit better in our big image. Okay, let's see. Bigger. You need to play a bit to find the best looking option for each brush, and maybe we can leave something like this. Let's see. To play a bit and to find the one that suits best your needs. Okay, but of course my recommendation is to stick to your original clouds, because generally they are the most natural looking for your image. So, I hope this video was useful, and now you know how to fix your clouds. So, take care, stay curious, and love the planet. If you found this video useful and informative, don't forget to hit the subscribe and the like button, and also the notification bell. See you, bye!